Assalamualaikum. My name is Siti Asyamah binti Shamuddin. My matrix number is CE210080. So we are from group EG4 of IDP and our project is titled Solar Energy Based Detection of Forest Fire. So this is the members of EG4, which is Nagalena, Danish Aiman, Shahira and myself, Siti Aisha. So for this video, I'm going to present about introduction of our project, which is Solar Energy Based Detection of Forest Fire. But this project is for addressing the increasing necessity for renewable energy resources due to global warming, greenhouse gas emissions, and fluctuating oil prices. By utilizing solar energy, which is abundant and sustainable, the project aims to develop a model for early forest fire detection. Solar photovoltaic cells and thermal system will harness solar power, which is then used to monitor and detect forest fire through strategically placed sensor.
All right, today, I'm going to explain about the problem statement of this project. Problem statement of this project is the forest fire, the existing nature of the system that can cause extensive damage to ecosystems, property, and humans. Early detection is critical in mitigating the impact of this fire. In the traditional method of forest fire detection, such as nuclear energy, through a sensor, can be expensive and maybe inexpensive. And we are bringing innovative approach to address this issue is the use of solar energy power detection system. That's it for me. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Nur Syairah binti Muhammad Saleh with matrix number DE210050. I would like to explain about the objective. The first objective is develop solar powered sensors with high sensitivity for early detection of forest fire. For this project, we are using flame sensor and analog temperature sensor module as a main sensor to collect data. Second objective is integrate real-time data processing and transmission technology for rapid alert dissemination. Basically, we are using Arduino Uno as a microcontroller and GSM module to notify specific mobile number by SMS. The third one is optimize energy efficiency to ensure an interrupt autonomous operation in remote forest area. So that's all for objective. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Muhammad Din Shaiman Biramdan. Today, I will explain how our prototype is working. So, first thing first, we are using Arduino Uno as a microcontroller. And we have two main sensors, which is flame sensor and LM35. And we are using GSM module to send notify to the user, and we have relay to control the water pump, and we have battery source to give source for generate water pump, and we have buzzer to trigger the alarm. Alright, so we are using two main sensor, which is flame sensor to detect fire detection, and LM35 for measure surrounding temperature. So basically, we are using solar to generate power for our microcontroller, and this is our solar power charger controller. So we can see this. We have connect the battery to the solar charger controller. We can see the logo battery connect to the load. And this is our voltage, and this is our temperature. Unfortunately, I record this video during night, so it's the same that we are connect to solar. If we are connect to direct sunlight, we can see the logo at here. We have the sunlight logo. So now I will show how our prototype working. Okay, now I will show the demonstration. So the fire is detected, and our pump is working right now, and the alarm is triggered. And the last thing, the GSM module will send the notification to the telephone number of user. Thank you.